My dear brothers and sisters, let us praise the Lord for His wonderful deeds in our lives. Let us thank the Lord for being very generous towards us. Let us praise and worship Him for being so good to all of us, for giving us this an opportunity to be in His presence. My dear friends, let us be sincere with our Lord at this time in communicating with Him about our real self. The topic on which we are going to discuss is my sense. He is the owner of our life. Let us place ourselves in the presence of our God, who is present here in the Blessed Sacrament. Ask Him earnestly to inspire you. Try to remember when you began to sin. Note that from this first beginning, sins have greatly multiplied in your heart. Day by day, your sins have increased against God, against yourself, against your neighbor, by deed, by word, by desire and thought. Dear brothers and sisters, let us be grateful to our God for being so generous towards us, for giving us a wonderful family, for giving us our daily bread, for giving us jobs, for giving us a good atmosphere, good health, blessings through the day. At this time, let us offer and surrender our whole being to the Lord. Speak to Him. Speak to Him what is happening to you now at this time, deep within you. Ask the Lord to be with you. He is the Creator. He has time for us. Only we have very little time for God. Lord Jesus Christ, meek and humble of heart, we have come in your presence to reflect on our lives, especially on the topic, my sins, my ingratitude to you. Lord, help me to go deep within myself for the love of you and see those elements which are unbecoming in me, those elements that are destroying my life, those elements that have become hindrance towards my going, entering into the kingdom of heaven. Lord Jesus Christ, I trust in you, Lord. I hope in you, Lord. I seek for your blessings every day and night. I depend on you totally for my every breath that I breathe, and likewise for every activity that I take up during this day. And hence, Lord, bless me, my family, bless my community, bless everyone around me, all those with whom I communicate, bless my tongue, bless my mind, my brain, bless my ears, my eyes, my nose, bless my heart, that I may be clean in body and spirit. Lord, I seek your blessings, your assistance at this time through the Holy Spirit as we sing together.
Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, one more time. Move in me, Holy Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, one more time. Move in me, Holy Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, one more time. Move in me, Holy Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, move in me, Holy Spirit, one more time.
My dear brothers and sisters, we are reflecting on the topic, My Sins. Once again, I remind you, try to remember when you began to sin. Note that from this first beginning, sins have greatly multiplied in your heart. Day by day, your sins have increased against God, against yourself, against your neighbor, by deed, by word, by desire, and by thought. Think of your evil inclinations at this time, and to what extent you have followed them. From these two points, you will realize that your sins are greater in number than the hair of your head. As it is said in Psalm 40, verse 12. Indeed, more than the sand of the earth. Consider by itself the sin of ingratitude to God. It is a general sin spreading itself to all the others and making them much more serious. Look at the numerous benefits God has given you, which you have all misused against the giver. Remember especially the many inspirations to which you have paid no attention, and the many good movements you made useless. Above all, my dear friends, you have received the sacraments many times, but where are the fruits, the precious jewels with which your dear spouse adorned you are all buried beneath your sins? What preparation did you make to receive the sacraments? Reflect on this ingratitude, my dear brother and sister, that while God was running after you constantly to save you, you were always running away from Him to ruin yourself. God is gracious in every way. He guides our way. He leads our way. He accompanies us in life. But we fail to receive Him. We fail to recognize Him we fail to see His company. My dear friends, let us give vent to good movements of the will and make deliberate decisions. First of all, be filled with shame at your wretchedness. My God, how dare I come in your presence? I am only the filth of the world and a sewer of ingratitude and wrongdoing. How thoroughly disloyal I have been. There is not a single one of my senses or the powers of my spirit which I have not spoiled, misused, or soiled. Not a single day of my life has passed on which I have not done much evil. What a return I have made for the blessings of my Creator and for the blood of my Savior. My dear friends, secondly, ask pardon. Throw yourself at our Lord's feet like a prodigal child, as we read in Luke chapter 15, verses 18 to 21. Like a sinful woman in Luke chapter 7, verses 37 and 38. Like a wife who has been most unfaithful to her husband. Lord, show mercy to me, a sinner. Living fountain of compassion, have pity on me, so full of misery. My dear brothers and sisters, thirdly, be determined to live a better life. No, Lord, never again, with the help of your grace. No, never again will I give myself up to sin. Say it again and again in your lives. Say it to yourself, say it to God, say it to others. Alas, I have loved it very greatly. I despise it and hold on to you, merciful Father. In you I want to live and die. My dear brothers and sisters, fourthly, I will confess my past sins with courage so that they will be wiped away. Every one of them I will drive out. Confession is very important. To get our sins cleansed and to begin anew in the Lord. My dear friends, fifthly, I will completely root out sin from my heart, doing all I can for this, especially such and such that are most troublesome. My dear brothers and sisters, finally, the sixth one, I will constantly use the means recommended to me in order to realize all the above. I will never think that I have done enough to make up for such serious faults. In my confessions, my confessor will guide me. He will help me. He will forgive me through my Lord. I must take courage and rise up and begin anew by the grace of God. To conclude, thank God who has waited for you till this very hour and has given you these good desires. Offer your heart to Him in order to realize them. Pray to Him for strength and so on. Let us pray the Our Father and Hail Mary together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. My dear friends, let us remain silent and be true to yourself when you reflect on the passage taken from the Introduction to the Devout Life by St. Francis de Sales, Part 1, Chapter 12. Say the prayer to Saint Francis de Sales with total devotion and keeping in mind the intentions you have, with a heart dedicated and committed to Him. Let us pray earnestly. Please repeat after me. O Blessed Francis,
O Blessed Francis,
who in your life
did excel in all virtues,
especially in your love of God and of your neighbor, I earnestly ask to take me under your immediate protection,
To obtain from God
my perfect conversion
and that of all sinners.
Teach me, O Father, to fix my eyes on heaven.
That I may generously trample underfoot
every obstacle that presents itself in my way
and attain that degree of glory
which you in your mercy
hold out to me.
Obtain also the favor
for which I now pray.
Assist us, O Lord.
We beseech you.
Through the merits of Saint Francis de Sales,
that what our endeavors
cannot obtain,
that what our endeavors cannot obtain,
may be given to us by His intercession.
May be given to us by His intercession.
O God,
O God,
who for the salvation of souls,
who for the salvation of souls,
did will. That Saint Francis de Sales, should become all things to all men and women. Mercifully grant that we, helped by the gentleness of His charity, guided by his teachings and sharing in his merits
may obtain eternal happiness.
This we ask
through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Dear friends, let us raise our hands towards heaven and ask the Lord for healing upon each one of us. Lord Jesus Christ, meek and humble of heart, we ask you, our dear Master of life, to take total possession of us and grant us our needs. We present to you ourselves the way we are. We ask you to grant us healing touch, especially on those of us who are weak and fragile. Bless us with your grace of good health and serenity in life. We ask you to bless our family members and community members. Bless our parents, children, and all of us present. Bless those who are sick in our families with your healing, we pray. We pray especially for those who live in sin and are wanting to return to you in repentance of the heart. Lord, bless us who are weak in body and soul. Bless with healing for those who are suffering from one or the other sicknesses or diseases. Lord, heal those who are suffering with brain diseases and Alzheimer's. Bless with healing those who are suffering with sicknesses in their eyes, ears, nose, throat, mouth, tongue, neck, chest, breast, stomach, sexual organs, eyes, knees, ankles, and feet. Bless those who are suffering from tumors, fevers, cancers, malaria, dengue, COVID-19, etc. Bless with healing for those who have undergone surgeries and are worried about their recovery. Lord, heal those on their deathbed and bless those who have given up hope in life. Bless those who are tense and worried in life about their jobs and security. Bless those who are poor and are marginalized. Bless those who are harassed and tortured. Bless those who are facing injustice and loss of property and housing. Bless those who are waiting for the right judgment from courts and judges. Bless those who are depressed and worried. Bless the elders and those neglected in our homes. Lord, bless those who are suffering with hatred in their own families and religious communities. God bless our country with peace. Bless the world with unity and harmony. Lord, thank you for your healing, all of us, and for your healing touch. Amen, amen, amen. My dear friends, as we thank the Lord, let us bow in adoration as we sing the benediction.
sacrament so great. Here is new and perfect worship. All the old must terminate. Senses cannot grasp this marvel. Faith must serve to compensate. Glory, honor, adoration. Let us sing in one accord. Praise be God Almighty Father. Spirit, Triune Godhead be adored. Amen.
Don't sow your desires in someone else's garden. Just cultivate your own as best you can. Don't long to be other than what you are, but desire to be thoroughly what you are. Don't sow your desires in someone else's garden. Just cultivate your own as best you can. Don't long to be other than what you are, but desire to be totally what you are. Direct your thoughts to being very good, and that and to bearing the crosses, little or great, that you will find there. Believe me, this is the most important. Direct your thoughts to being very good, at that and to bearing the crosses, little or great, that you will find there. At least understood, point to the spiritual life. Don't sow your desires in someone else's garden. Just cultivate your own as best you can. Don't long to be other than what you are, but desire to be thoroughly what you are.